Welcome to the Emerald. Please collect our welcome package on the pedestal and sign in at the front desk. A message from the director will play momentarily. Thank you.
What is this place? I certainly wasn't expecting this. Went to investigate leak in the structure. Those pesky sharks have been at it again. I'll be back before lunch. The greeter. I don't think anyone is coming. Who this is.
Welcome to the Emerald Maiden. Here you will begin a great journey into the realm of dreams. A luxurious gateway destination for the world's elite. Treat yourself at our bar, dance in our illustrious ballroom, or visit our botanical gardens. A sight that would awe even the most seasoned of tourists. But that's not why you're here, is it? You're here to release yourself from the prison of reality. Infinite worlds are yours to explore through our dream machine. Powered by an ancient civilization's technology, here magic meets science. The only limit? Your imagination. At midnight, the show begins. For now, explore. We will meet soon. I am the director, and here you will find my symphony of dreams. I hope it's everything you dreamed of.
Hey there, miss. Another weary traveler. You're the first visitor I've had in some time. A few regulars, of course, but they aren't very nice. Listen, I'm sure you're here on official business, but would you do me a kindness? Flip that switch on that stage across the way. I've got limited abilities to engage with the real world. I'm sure you understand.
So there are people here. Was that the director? There you go, little guy. Looks like someone's been here recently. Scientist log, May 7, 1957. The presence of Dream Machine appears to affect wildlife. The animals behave far more aggressively when captured for study. We have conducted extensive safety reviews, and all known frequencies appear well within regulatory standards for emissions. A full report is being prepared by the Dream Corporation. It's rusted shut, it won't budge. I better fix the light so I don't lose my way in the dark.
There was once a great explorer who met a brilliant young scientist. Together they traveled the world. One day they found an ancient, mysterious artifact. With that artifact came great power. They used this magic to harness the power of dreams. But the artifact had a will of its own and would not be contained. The scientist set her mind to battle the evil, but she was overcome, and into nightmares she fell.
Thanks. You've brightened my day, or night. Hard to tell down here. Take this. I was supposed to hide it, but it may come in handy.
It won't open. What an odd symbol, though. Oh my, I wonder who that was. London Daily News, Monday, February the 21st, 1955, the Dream Corporation has announced its first successful test of a new machine dubbed the Dream Machine. It promises to be an experience like no other, in which ordinary people, for a not-so-ordinary price, can experience near-lucid dreams indistinguishable from reality. Much controversy surrounds this recent discovery, and the corporation has been very secretive about its research. Yours truly, the director. Seems to be a postcard that the director gave to his guests. Looks like the jar has been smashed. Perhaps I'll find another. I always wanted to go on the safari. Has it really been only a year since we turned from the Amazon and made our discovery? I should have never brought that dreaded thing here. We must take her to the surface. This place is no longer safe.
Welcome to the Dream Machine, your gateway to true simulated environments. We won't bore you with bosons, photons, and quantum entanglements. Let's just call it secret technology. Users may experience any dream they choose. Dreams are stored on our patented cloud cards. The dream world is limitless. Though horseplay is never advised, you cannot be harmed in the dream world. Items from our world cannot be interpreted in the dream world, so leave your camera behind. No pictures. As a dreamer, you are encouraged to take back a souvenir, anything you like. Nothing dangerous or alive. Please, dream responsibly. This message has been brought to you by the Dream Corporation.
Dream Corporation, book your dream today. This must be one of the flyers from the launch of the Dream Machine. I gotta admit that I don't feel safe here.
be? How could she have found you?
My love, I offer you a rose as a sign of my love. Roses wilt and eventually cease to exist. So I offer you my dreams, a true token. Dreams never fade, and my love for you will never die. Yours truly.
Alice Williams, take this ring as a sign of my faith and commitment to our love. And share this dream with me today.
What's that clanking I hear coming from the vent? It's too dark to see what's below. Looks like there used to be a ring in this box. The statue's heads are missing. Dream Corporation Scientist Log, March 25th, 1956. Recent studies have shown that the mysterious glowing plankton may serve as an excellent form of lighting. This newfound discovery is being engineered for use aboard the Emerald. Those phytoplankton require very little nutrition to carry on breeding for years at a time. What an amazing discovery. We're lost here. Our two worlds are becoming one. This is our only hope. Take her to the surface, for you ever, or forever yours, Alice. Don't worry, kitty. I'll find a way to free you. This appears to be the cause of that crack. Who could have done this? That's a pretty big crack. Someone's got a temper.
My husband and I have traveled to the Amazon jungle, unexplored by modern man. We search for a lost artifact. A local tribe has directed us here to a sacred place spoken of in their legends, dating back thousands of years. This artifact possesses great power and could be a significant stepping stone in our research into the subconscious mind.
To protect the Empress, the guards see not face to face, while the father's son kneels, gazing off into outer space. Father watches the Empress, knowing his love is true, while the Empress stands looking forth with eyes only for you. Riverview Daily, young scientist working on secret project. September 26, 1956, on a Sunday. Alice Williams has a background in physics and the study of ancient people and cultures. She currently works on a project known as the Dream Machine, kept secret by the Dream Corporation. This poster is advertising Paris. Is that the dream that I'll be visiting soon? Phone number must be important.
You've grown, and you look just like her. You startled me in the lobby earlier. It's hard to tell what's real anymore. I don't have time to explain. Your mother is here too, but that's something you'll have to see for yourself. Meet me in the lower levels. The code to access the elevator is 34593. The director is surely lurking these halls somewhere. I suggest you stay out of his way.
That was the nurse from earlier. I better head to the elevator. Someone destroyed the elevator controls. Technical note, if the memory chip becomes disconnected or if the bot is disassembled, all memory will be lost. The helper bot will reset to factory default settings. Helper bot 2000, the personal robotic assistant, by your side 24/7. Your new pet has many functions, including a security system. Simply install the locks in your home or business, and only your new pet bot can assess them. What's going on in there? What's in there? It looks like some kind of theater. Hello, ma'am. My name's Adam. It's nice to meet you. I love to be of assistance and specialize in personal security. Look for my logo, and I think we'll make great friends. Is this Paris? I've only seen it in pictures. Incredible. Different strange symbol. Why are the binoculars pointed straight at it? I bet I could open it with an item that matches the shape. That monkey, how did it get there? Is that from the Amazon? A record must go here. Maybe the recording will tell me something important. Dream Corporation Scientist Log, January 24, 1957. There's a strange occurrence in the lab today. I noticed a creature from a non-physical dream somehow manifesting itself in reality, rummaging through the beakers to lock up. Rummaging through the beakers and lockup. It's hard to deal with. I feel we could be toying with the force that simply doesn't correlate with our current understanding of physics.
It's my belief that ancient peoples found a way to harness the power of this artifact, to control their dreams, bridging the gap between reality and mere illusion. They called these peoples dreamwalkers. I've arranged a meeting with the head chief of the tribe. Perhaps we can catch a glimpse of this artifact and, in a best case, have a chance to study it. So exciting. Stay tuned for more.
Perhaps if I free him, he'll give me the piano key. Dream Corporation, Scientist Log, May 7, 1957. The tribe has migrated south since the rendezvous at the mountain peak. They express noticeable anxiety when handling the artifact. My husband and I have been tracking them across the jungle in hopes of catching a glimpse and perhaps offering an exchange to study it. I need to get that kitten down from there. Half a pair of shears isn't very useful. Thank you.
You've arrived. Time is of the essence, dear. This is the reunion you have sought. Now, your mother should have left something with you. A gift. It is the key to her salvation. Look for the lens and see her plight.
So many years, Alice, and I still cannot release you. I grow so weary. She taunts me with your image and that of our daughter. You! But how? Run! She's not who she says she is.
Run? There's nowhere to hide. I am master here. You think I can be defeated? I have lived in one form or another for millennia. You cannot protect your dreams. My reach shall be wider. My footsteps will fall on the earth again. You have that which I seek, and it will be mine.
That was quite the fall. I'm lucky to be alive. Aw, poor creature. It looks like she's missing her babies. I'm not sticking my hand in there until that rat is taken care of.
Doug has been cooking up something amazing for the project. He's working on a matter transformer for the dream machine. Apparently, this thing can manipulate space within the simulation, physically altering it. We've made so many leaps in the technology over the last few weeks. We've really started to unlock the secrets of the artifact as we study it in greater detail. My biggest fear right now is that we've discovered something too powerful to risk returning it to its people. I've got all of my chips on the Dream Corporation right now. I just hope I'm making the right choice.
good. You've awoken. I was starting to become quite concerned for you. You had quite a little ride back there. Yes, you did. The name's Doug. I'm a scientist here at Dream Corporation. I used to work with the brilliant Alice Williams before she fell into... Well, before she fell into the unfortunate state she's in now. Sad, sad, sad. Not that I'm looking much better. Been down here 25 long years, trying to eradicate that evil spirit once and for all. Your trip down the elevator shaft tells me that you had the distinct pleasure of meeting her as well. I came across something in the lobby that might be of use to you. It's all yours if you can do me a little favor. Could you go back to my childhood home, via the dream machine, of course, and bring me back my science fair trophy? It'd mean a great deal to me.
Is that fur? Locked. Why bother in such an isolated place? Oh, wow. Frozen solid. Brr, it's too cold to dig with my hands. Like someone drilled the ice here at some point. Thank you.
Ah, you found my trophy. This certainly does bring back memories. As promised, here's the object I found in the lobby earlier. I trust it'll come in handy. I do have something else as well, which should help you out a great deal. I made a device that can aid in your quest to shut down the dream machine for good. But the blueprints are missing. Misplaced, I suppose you could say. Find the blueprints, and I can build this device for you.
Father! Another one of my illusions, my dear. He's been captive ever since he tried to save your mother. Foolish decision, if you ask me. But who am I to judge?
Usher, this wool is horribly itchy, so I left a back scratcher in case you need it. And it even doubles as a reaching stick. Cheers, Alice Williams.
Oh, and while you were about, did you by chance see my kitties? They climbed up the ventilation shaft and are now scattered around the Emerald Maiden. I do worry for them. It's not safe up there. If you find them, bring them back to their mother over in the other room there, would you?
Oh, my beautiful feline princess is having babies. So excited, I wonder how many she'll have.
Apparently, another group of researchers has been sweeping the area. I've yet to meet them. Rumor around the settlement is that they're a team from Prague, a couple of rogue archaeologists set on obtaining the artifact. We're keeping a close eye on the situation, but the Dream Corporation is getting impatient. They wanted the machine running yesterday, and neither of us has been able to reach a deal with Okiwan leaving the grounds to study it. We're heading to Prague to meet with Mr. Weathers in a month. Perhaps we'll learn something about the other group, unless we cross paths before leaving the settlement.
Greetings, stranger. You're not associated with the explorers that came here previously, are you? For your sake, I hope not. They came to our village as guests, this man and woman, but then destroyed our sacred plants, and then robbed our temple. What's more, they destroyed the bridge into town, leaving me unable to return. Please, if you are truly not with them, could you help me fix this bridge? I will be able to give you a small reward, as well as my trust. Thank you. You've proven that you are a friend, and so I can trust you to go to the temple. And as promised, a small reward for your efforts. The bananas here are delicious. You must be hungry after all that work. Another stranger, huh? More trustworthy than the last, I hope. Those thieves have stolen our sacred property. They don't realize the incredible power of the object that they are just treating as a mere curiosity. They've scattered my toucans as well, as if simply robbing our temple weren't enough. I need to get them back. Will you aid me? I would be greatly indebted to you. Here, take this bird seed. It'll help in their recapture. thank you. You've proved and has promised to.
Ah, thank you, friend. This has been a terrible incident in our village's history, and I greatly appreciate your kindness. I have a gift for you, my spare bow. I hope it serves you well in your quest.
Doug, I noticed you hadn't filled out the line art for the painting yet. I left this note here knowing you'd be tinkering with the speaker at some point soon. This painting looks amazing so far. You're such a multi-talented man and a true honor to work with. Here's some extra paint if you need any. Cheers, Alice Williams.
Thank you. The new and improved helper bot, the pride of Dream Core Engine.
The liquid solution we've developed to house the mask seems to provide a sustainable oxygen supply for normal operations. Coincidentally, the same levels required to sustain human lungs. I've been toying with the idea of suspending myself in order to establish some kind of interface with the dream machine, or whatever essence is its true source of power. But it's a scary notion, considering what we've experienced as far as interference with the local wildlife. The sharks have been at it again all week, slamming into the ejection bay doors and plankton retrieval hubs. One of these days, I'm scared they're gonna crack the solarium dome and flood the whole place. Some days, I almost wish they would.
Dreamers, those pesky sharks have been slamming themselves at the reserve all week, and it's been totally destroyed. I've disabled the controls and set conditions for them to re-enable once the plankton reserve located just outside has been repaired. Staff, don't use this suit. The oxygen tank isn't connected. If you have to, a spare glove is in the helmet, and some loose tanks should be under the stage. You have to fetch the key, though. My husband dropped it between the cracks earlier today, and it's tough to reach. Good luck.
I knew this would happen. I knew something was wrong. This has gotten out of hand. My husband has brought the baby to the surface. I had to convince him I was running a simple test. This is my final attempt. The spirit has locked the entire facility. I'm gonna shut this thing down the only way I know how. Everything is in place. To whoever finds this real, my name is Alice Williams, and I've created a monster. Please tell my daughter I'm sorry, and to my husband. This was the only way.
Hello again. Still running, are we? I need that emerald you wear about your neck, and I will have it. I can make your dreams into nightmares, your deepest fears your reality. But I'm not completely heartless. I'm open to offering you a deal. Give in and sleep. The dream world is so much more pleasant. No pain, no responsibility, no suffering the slow aging of your mortal body. And to think you could even be reunited with your mother and father. Don't you want that? I think they would want that.
Hey, no trespassing, you. This museum has already been broken into once tonight, and it is certainly not going to happen again. Not on my watch, or on the watch of the alarm security system inside.
Thank you.
This is not good.
Ancient artifact 01, retrieved from the Amazon jungle, thought to have mysterious mind-controlling abilities. Can its power be tamed? Alice, I'm sorry, my dear. I couldn't let the other explorers take it away from us. We worked so hard. Your face, when we left the village, simply crushed me. You love those people. I'm breaking into the museum and taking back what's ours.
We're heading back to America on a ship across the Atlantic Ocean. It's been a week since the incident in Prague. I can't believe we pulled it off without getting caught. It serves them right for stealing from the settlement. I vow to return this artifact to its people as soon as our technology has been adapted. This is the first time in my life that I feel I've accomplished something great. But I can't shake the lingering thought that something is just not right about this.
Oh, you managed to round up all my kitties? Admittedly, I was getting a little lonely down here without them. By the sounds of things, they're happy to be back with their mother. Oh, yes, yes, yes. You've put together the matter transformer. Wonderful. This device will be integral in defeating that spirit. I know that Alice set up a secret location in every dream that you can affect with the matter transformer. These locations will yield 5 keys, which are necessary to decrypt the password for the dream machine's self-destruct mechanism. And then, a kaboom! I do believe you are now ready to take on that terrible spirit. Don't you worry about me and my kitties. Oh, we'll be just fine. Fine, fine, fine. And I might say, it has been an honor working with the wonderful Alice Williams' own daughter. Best of luck!
think you're doing, dear? You don't seriously believe that will stop me, do you? End this foolishness immediately. You cannot defy me. Worthless efforts. I've become too powerful for the confines of this machine. Give up now, or pay the price. You're only making your parents suffer, selfish girl. I will drown them in nightmares. They will only know fear. No! Enough! Do not be so foolish and think that this ends here. I have survived for millennia. Do you truly think that you and your little keys can defeat me? You don't want to do this. I can grant you the most wondrous of dreams. Show you things you couldn't imagine.
With me now, together at last. A bond made 25 years ago, tested by extraordinary today simply marks the beginning of a new chapter in our lives.
You have come upon a great misfortune, all of you. You've survived the destruction of a facility that's no longer of any interest to the Dream Corporation. A relic of our past failures. We've been trying to recover the artifact, and lo and behold, you brought it right into my hands. Now its power is mine. Ah, today's a new day. I'm afraid to say you've witnessed too much. But nothing to worry about. We have plans for clever little people like you. Take them away.
Oh, my, my. You've grown into such a fine young lady. I'd love to catch up, but we must flee from here immediately.
Find a way to release this lock, and please, take caution. The Dream Corporation are a dangerous bunch, and they do not take kindly to anyone poking around in their business.
Hey, keep it down in there. You got no business complaining. You brought this on yourself. What was that? Oh, great. I better go check it out. Pathetic. I'm not that stupid. What are you gonna do next? Play sick? Oldest trick in the book.
Please, you must hurry, my...
Ah, you made it out? The name's Randy. Been fishing these seas for almost 30 years. Listen, sweetheart. Move along and I won't say nothing. I'm used to turning the other cheek around these parts. If I were you, I'd head to the lighthouse across the way. They've been setting up something big there. Rumor has it they plan to use some artifact to control the world. Some sort of mind control device or something. If you find a way to stop them, come and see me. I'll get you and your folks out of here. Take this. Perhaps it'll help you out. Good luck to you.
Hey, man. Lady. The name's Marty. What brings you to the beach? If you're wondering why I set up camp here, let me fill you in. Those snaky grubs from Dream Corp rolled into town and stole the show. I've heard whispers of some underwater theater that they're trying to yank some artifact out of, but that's none of my business, man. My gripe is that they blocked off the lighthouse and made me park my van on the beach to stay out of the way. Such a bummer. They expected that I'd just bug out, but that's not how I roll, man. I need to be free. Politics, eh? Man, I'm thirsty. Listen, you bring me a rainbow soda from the machine in town, and I'll give you something super cool. What do you say?
Oh, and by the way, if you see my captain's hat lying around anywhere, would you mind returning it? Sailing ain't the same in this itchy old wool.
Come on, you're killing me, lady. You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. You dig?
Ah, blasted net. You'd better run fast. I'm not the only agent on duty. You'll be caught in no time.
The power of that artifact has plagued me for years. I must have it. The missing eye is useless to me without the mask. It must be fully functional to carry out our plans. Judging by the shape of the emerald at half capacity,
I can only imagine what will come of it at full power. We need the girl to buckle under the weight of its power and give herself up. It's the only way. It wants her. She's the final puzzle piece. And once it has her, then perhaps it will join us. Or we will find a way to take it by force.
Blasted net!
What brings you to the swap shop here today, young lady? Oh, don't mind the mess. My son is quite, active. He's a little sour since I took his toy train away. But it's a fair punishment for running around the shop and knocking over my fine china. It's left me drinking from a bait can. Ugh. Not very ladylike, to say the least. The gate leading to our car has been blocked off, so we're kind of sitting ducks at the moment. If you're looking to reach the lighthouse, there's a sewer tunnel that leads right to it. But I'm parked over the manhole. You think you can do me a favor? You bring me a teacup and I'll give you the keys for the car so you can move it out of the way. While you're there, you might as well grab Devin's train. That poor boy needs something to keep him busy while I run the shop. But that teacup is priority one. I can't stand drinking from this filthy old thing much longer.
Well, ma'am, how's the day treating you? You didn't happen to see my toy train anywhere, did you? I'm so bored. There's not really any other kids left in town since those big mean men started running things. Speaking of which, I saw one of them drop a key card this morning and I yanked it when he wasn't looking. I think they were using it to unlock that trailer where they keep all their fancy gadgets. I bet you could find lots of cool stuff in there. Find me my train and the key card's all yours.
Whoa, you pulled through! Gnarly! I hope you're able to take out that machine they've been building at the lighthouse. Call me Mr. Conspiracy if you want, but I heard they plan to take over the world with it. Mind control, man! Anyway, thanks for the soda. Deal's a deal. Here's your reward.
We're so close. I've assembled the final blueprints for the team. It looks like this device may see its day. A simple interface from the transistors to the artifact should work flawlessly. The next step is getting our hands on it. All of the transmission components are in place. As soon as the satellite leaves the Earth's gravity, we're in business. As long as we nail the trajectory, it should settle into a polar orbit, and the rest is as easy as pie. The entire globe will be covered, every inch. Communication links have already been established to the satellite on the ground. I'm so proud. This technology is leaps and bounds ahead of the space program, and the calculations are staggering in comparison. We're hoping to achieve something big here, and most importantly, gain control over our enemies and friends alike. Nothing can stop us. It looks like our friend has arrived right on time. We'll see how she fares in the theater. She's the only one that the spirit will allow to enter the building without a fight. Talk about bitter over past experiences. I'm glad it didn't come to sending my men down there. I bet we could throw an atomic bomb at that thing and still not break the barrier. Hopefully everything goes as planned. As soon as I take possession of the artifact, work can begin fitting it to the rocket. I can already feel the world in the palm of my hands.
Nice try! A clever mind you have, just like your mother. Did you honestly think you destroyed the artifact when you blew up my rocket? Ha! Hardly! I've yet to even install it. In fact, I plan to do much more with this. I'll let you go for now. Go on. Carry on your lives as a happy little family. But remember one thing. You're on my mind. You'll always be on my mind. And one day, our paths will cross again.
Mm-hmm.